Good day, everyone. Alice here from Sofi Financial Network. Today is December 22nd, 2022. And today market, this is a daily analysis. Today market had a very, very wild action. I didn't expect market stalled out today. I thought that market will have a positive week. The next week we will have a stalled out. But seems like the bearish momentum still is there, and all the buyers actually have gone toasted today. And you see that market just went all the way down to here to just make a lower low, a nominal lower low, and then bouncing back up just after the last half an hour, market just bounced back up. And if you see the daily intraday action, which we are going to cover it in a few minutes, you will see the early chart actually market just bounced back up last hour or so. So today, the volume for S&P 500 was very light, like less than 70 million. And that is the indication that there was no institution sellers. It's just the retail sellers that came back to this area, which is pretty nice supply area, I would say. Again, this is my rectangular I show you yesterday in daily analysis. If you haven't seen that, make sure to see that. Make sure that see all the daily analysis, which I'm covering day by day, so you will understand what I'm talking about exactly. But this is the area that I was looking for, 3,900 to 3,950. But market didn't have a power to get to that level. So market just stalled out. And this is very, very similar. I'm not sure if you're seeing the same thing, but this is very, very similar to this pattern. If you see that market had like a top in March, then coming down, then bounce back up, sharp sell-off, and then build up the consolidation, kind of like a supply area before this pivotal point. And just above this pivotal point, build up the supply area, just market went all the way down, then all the orders beaten up, and market just came back up, test this level, and then lower low. So I think we are at the beginning of process, something like this. So the price action is very, very similar. We had top, we came down, we have a demand area, here's the pivotal point, so build up the consolidation. Some kind of like a supply area consolidation to build up or to beaten up all the orders, all the buy orders from here. And probably after that, when we see the completion of this supply area market, just to go all the way down to here and probably take out this lower low to test the bottom, the October bottom, and then market coming back up to the next supply level, and then sharp sell off to a lower low, probably end of the January, middle to the end of the January to February. I would see another lower low, probably 3,200 to 3,400 is going to be possible scenario for myself. So again, any pullback to the upside, we are waiting for a short setup. I didn't get a short setup because, again, I was waiting for another top, topping formation here to at least to test this area to the broken level. And then I will get back to the short side, as I explained yesterday, but unfortunately market didn't have enough momentum to the upside and just the stall out today after two green day or two positive days. All right, going to hourly chart. Here's the hourly chart, and market just fantastically reacted to this dynamic line. So look at that. So here's the dynamic line. We broken above, went above. So these are all levels we discussed yesterday, and I was waiting for this area. If you, again, I'm just referring you to the yesterday analysis. I talked about 3909 to 3946. That's going to be shorting area. I was waiting for that. Unfortunately, market didn't have enough power. Went all the way down, but look at the reaction. Like last 2 hours, here's the last 2 hours of the market. So just bouncing back up nicely, build up a bullish consolidation, and probably this bullish consolidation is having another pop to the upside and probably to this level. So let me just bring this one, or just copy this one, and copy this one here. So this is the area. that I'm looking for the maximum stretch for the upside for another shorting setup. So 38.48 from now, it's going to be just the 24, 26 units above it. But look what happened. What was the trigger? So this is not just dynamic trend line. This is the area that I was looking for. Here is the demand area. And this demand area is very, very strong just because this is a Federal Reserve pivotal point to the upside. And if we just want to exactly show you how market reacted nicely technically to that level, just a touch to 37.66 and then coming back up all the way just sharply to the upside. So again, this momentum can have followed through, more followed through to 38.48 maximum to this level. I'm not sure even if we get there. So the next level that I'm looking here is 38.48 to 38.64. So again, this is going to be the nice short setup for the S&P 500, all right? So let's move on to NASDAQ. Let me just go to NASDAQ. Here's the NASDAQ chart. Let's go to daily. So here is the daily chart. And daily chart, we had this analysis that we were expecting market is coming back up again for the NASDAQ. I was waiting for to 11,441 to get to the short side, but unfortunately market didn't give me a chance to trigger the short setup here. And today, ugly sell off to the downside. So just a remarkable lower low. And right now we just touched this area by a penny, just below this demand area. I'm going to cover this in hourly chart, but this is a nice reaction to this demand area. However, this is not a good chart. This is not a good chart for bulls, I would say. So I'm expecting NASDAQ is taking out any of these pivotal points very, very soon. So if I want to show you here, this is very, very important. So here's the top, here's the top, and here's the low, taking out with this, and probably these two levels, just because we don't have another higher high, and we just smashing down to the downside. If we take on this pivot low, so probably the next level would be here and here. So you see they're pretty close. So if we just pierce it to this level, this means this bearish flag is already intact and market will have another setup to the downside. So again, I'm not sure if we get there or not, but this bearish setup is pretty powerful. And if you want to just go with maximum stretch to the downside, I would say NASDAQ has a very, very high chance to get there to 9,750, which is very, very important area, just because that's going to be the top of the market prior COVID crash. And even if you want to just do a test, a maximum test, to see how symmetry works. So this is another trick, because I'm going to show you these ones just because this is going to be for educational purpose of as well. So this is going to be here. So if you want to just go in there. So this is going to be the maximum stretch for the downside, right? So this is going to be a symmetry and it's going to be just below this. So I'm going to take, this is the target for myself, like 9,750. But again, this point, which is the top of this, and this is the pivotal area, nicely works like 8,991. So that's going to be the level, the maximum level to the downside, and probably this is going to be the bottom of the market, I believe, in 2023. So this is going to be area four, NASDAQ, if you want to just nail it down. So this is going to be the bottom. Again, NASDAQ is the weakest index among the other ones. So don't bet on it for now. Technology is on the weaker side. However, on the other hand, the Dow Jones is very, very strong. So I know we had a very, very ugly sell-off today, but if you just compare the daily action, S&P 500 take out this pivotal point for itself. NASDAQ went all the way down to here, and Dow Jones still above its SMA 50 on the daily chart. It doesn't go below this. So this is very, very important. If you just compare these charts together, you will see if you want to be in long position, make sure position yourself in a better bull index. And the better one, or I should say the best one, is Dow Jones Industrial, right? So Dow Jones is very, very important just because that was the first one reaching out to the selling area. I was expecting another, again, like the other indexes, another spike to the upside, probably 33,631, which I show you in day intraday as well. So that was my level. I made it risk-free, by the way. So my second position actually stopped out at the break-even level. We took our profit for the first target, but unfortunately, we didn't have to take profit for the second target. Anyway, that was a good shorting setup, but unfortunately, market didn't give me any chance. But look at the strength of the chart. So still, we are above this trend line. We are above this pivotal point. We are above this pivotal point, and everything is working very, very well with Dow Jones. And I said, Dow Jones, if Dow Jones goes down all the way to 30,000 area, so probably the other indexes are making a lower low, while Dow Jones is making the higher low, and that's going to be a nice QM pattern for long position. And I believe you should position yourself in better indexes or better commodity asset or stocks, whatever you want to call it. And even if you want to just use a Fibonacci tool, which everyone should use time to time, here's the bottom of the COVID crash, and here's the top of the market. So we are at 38% retracement, right? So right now, even the current price is at 23% of the Fibonacci level. But for the other indexes, we went all the way down to 50%. Even for NASDAQ, it went down below 50%. So that shows, if you want to just use this symmetry to compare these stocks to each other, you should just use different tool to understand which one is the best. All right, so let's go to hourly chart. Here's the hourly chart for the Dow Jones. Again, Dow Jones is making very, very nice bullish consolidation. I would say the next level for the Dow Jones, it doesn't reach out to this level. And still, there is a probable scenario Dow Jones get back to the upside, even to this area, to make a higher high, because this bullish consolidation is very, very solid. And again, MACD is changing the position to the upside. So RSI is coming to the very, very oversold area in short term. And probably tomorrow we will have, or even in London session, we will have like a double top or higher high, while the other indexes are making lower high. And that's going to be the nice selling opportunity for us, right? So if you go, I just want to show you how I'm looking at the chart. So here is the area that I'm looking for, right? So this is going to be a nice setup for the short. So we will see. We will see if it gets there. Probably that's going to be a good try for the short setup. All right. I will let you know. I will let you know. But I'm not going to short Dow Jones. I'm just looking at the Dow Jones for the target area. And if Dow Jones gets there, I will look at NASDAQ to make another short position in NASDAQ instead of Dow Jones, right? Okay, I think I wrapped up everything. If you like this video, please smash the like button and subscribe to our channel. And that's going to be the least support from you folks. All right. All right. Have a wonderful evening. See you on the chart. Bye-bye.